So hello everyone, I welcome you all to my channel Regalia, and our today's topic is history of plant pathology. So first we'll see what are the topics that are being covered. First is about the history of plant pathogens, then we'll see history of host parasite relationships, history of viruses, disease resistance, history of plant disease and control, plant pathology in India, nematology in India, okay, economically important diseases. So we will see the history related to all these particular topics. So without wasting much of your time, let's hop into the video. Now first we'll see about plant pathogens, the history which is related to plant pathogens. So a very famous term, Michaeli, in 1729, he described many new genera of fungi in Nova Plantarum genera. So Nova Plantarum genera is a journal, or you can say it's a journal in which he described the many genera of fungi, and therefore he is also regarded as the father of mycology. Then Matthew Tillett, or M. Tillett, in 1755, he was the first to prove that bunt is contagious in wheat. So bunt is basically a fungal disease, and he was the first person who found out that it is contagious, or it is contagious in wheat, and therefore he is also regarded as the great grandfather of plant pathology. Then we will see Prevost. Prevost in 1807, he repeated the Tillett's experiments, and then he later proved that bunt is due to fungus. So bunt is basically caused by a fungus, and he studied the germination of smut spores and their inhibition by copper sulfate. So it's an important question that Prevost studied the smut spores, the germination, and its inhibition by copper sulfate. M. W. Beijerinck, father of virology, and he called virus as contagium vivum fluidum, or such kinds of fluid that are contagious in nature. Contagium vivum fluidum, and he also coined the term virus. Then is Needham. Needham found association of nematodes with leaf galls. Okay, nematode, what was the nematode? The nematode was Anguinia tritici. Okay, Anguinia tritici was the nematode, and it was found associated with leaf galls. Now the next is Doi et al. Doi et al, he discovered MLO, mycoplasma like organisms, also known as phytoplasma, in potato witch's broom disease. So potato witch's broom is a disease, and MLO was found associated with this disease. Next is Theodinier. So Theodinier, in 1971, the year is important, he discovered viroids that were associated with the potato spindle tuber virus disease. So PSTD, we say it in short form, PSTD, potato spindle tuber disease, and this disease is associated with viroids. Hasselhoff and Simons, in 1982, they discovered virusoids which are associated with the tobacco velvet disease. So tobacco velvet disease is caused by virusoids. What are virusoids? We will deal in the later chapter. Now we will see Prusner. Prusner discovered prions, for which he got Nobel Prize in Physiology. Okay, prions are infectious proteinaceous bodies. Infectious proteins, prions. Okay. Now next is Anton de Vary, father of plant pathology. Why he is known as the father of plant pathology? Because he was able to prove that the late blight of potato was caused by Phytophthora infestans. Late blight of potato was responsible for Irish famine, and had led to a huge catastrophe. And the person who brought the world out of that catastrophe was Anton de Vary, and therefore he is considered as the father of plant pathology. He also studied rust and smuts as causes of disease development. In 1865, he reported heterocesium in uridinales. Uridinales means black rust fungi. So he reported a particular character called heterocesium. So what is heterocesium? We will deal in the later chapter. In 1866, he published the book Morphology and Physiology of Fungi, Lichens and Myxomycetes. In 1886, he published the Physiology of Parasitism. So these are the particular books that he published. So if you want to learn the names, you can, but it's not that much important. Just learn that he is the father of plant pathology, and he was the first person to prove Apart from this, you can also learn that he reported the heterocious nature in uridinals, okay, the black rust fungi. Now is J.G. Kuhn. J.G. Kuhn is known as the father of modern plant pathology, and he wrote the first book in which fungi were regarded as casual agent. And the name of the book was Disease of Cultivated Crops, Their Causes and Their Controls. So it was the book which was written by J.G. Kuhn in which he firstly described fungi as the agent. Pasteur, in 7th April 1864, he performed a very famous experiment known as the Swan Net experiment to forfeit or to counteract the spontaneous theory. Okay. Oscar Breffeld is known as the father of pure culture technique. He gave pure culture technique of microorganisms. P.A. Millardet, in 1885, he discovered the famous Bordeaux mixture against the downy mildew of grapes. In some books, it is written powdery. Okay, but powdery is wrong. You should not go with powdery, it's the downy mildew of grapes. E.C. Stockman, 1913, he discovered the phenomenon of physiological specialization in rust. So, basically, rust has a number of strains like R1.1.2. like this. So, he discovered this particular strain types in rust, like the different strains. So this contribution goes to E.C. Stockman. Okay, host-parasite relationship. We will see now some of the history which is related to the host and the parasite relationship. So first is William Brown. William Brown, he told the role of enzymes to disintegrate plant tissues like lysozyme, okay, and various other enzymes that helps to dissociate the plant tissues. Muller and Borger, they coined the term phytoalexin. What is phytoalexin will be dealt in the later chapter, but for now just learn that they coined the term phytoalexin. Wagner coined the term phytotoxin and pathotoxin. Okay, Wagner, phyto and pathotoxin. Now, Van Loon, in 1985, he isolated the first pathogenesis-related proteins, PR proteins. So, these proteins, PR proteins, are produced during infection. Okay, during infection, such types of proteins are produced, and pathogenesis-related proteins. Robert Hartig, he is the father of forest pathology, and he worked on diseases of forest trees. So he is the father of forest pathology, so it is very much understood that he was working on forest trees. Erwin F. Smith is the father of bacteriology. Okay, father of bacteriology, Erwin F. Smith. Now you will see about viruses. Viruses, in the case of viruses, the first name comes is of Adolf Meyer, and he first time reported the infectious nature of sap from broken tulip. So it is asked in the examination that the first viral disease that was reported was, so it is the broken tulip disease. Okay, now broken tulip is a viral disease, but at that time it was thought to be a characteristics of the tulip flower, that it was so much magnificent that the petals were curled or it was broken, but it was actually a disease which was later discovered. Bejerink, father of virology, because he gave the term contagium vivum fluidum, and he discovered that the fluid had a contagious nature. Father of virology. W.M. Stanley, isolation of crystalline protein possessing TMV like properties. So he isolated the crystalline protein nature from the viruses, and for that he used ammonium sulfate. It is a very important question. Important for examination, like they ask that what was the chemical that was used by Stanley to crystallize proteins. It was ammonium sulfate. Borden and Pieri, he reported the nucleoprotein nature of TMV. Because many people know that Borden and Pieri, they reported the nucleoprotein nature, but in which disease? In the bushy stunt virus disease of tomato. Okay, so they reported the nucleoprotein nature of TMV in the bushy stunt virus of tomato, Borden and Pierre. Now we will see Cassanis. Cassanis, they coined the term satellite virus. Okay, Cassanis. Harrison et al., they classified plant virus into 16 groups, and they coined the term Gemini viruses. Gemini viruses is a group of viruses with single-stranded DNA with them. Okay, so it is important because being a plant virus, it should be RNA, but it is a single-stranded DNA. That too, a single-stranded DNA. DNA is usually found double-stranded, but this Gemini virus has single-stranded DNA, so it's important. Shepherd first reported double-stranded DNA in colimovirus, in cauliflower mosaic virus. So double-stranded DNA also important. Kohler and Milstein hybridoma technology for monoclonal antibody production. So it is what is actually hybridoma technology is not in our syllabus, so we should not look into it, but we should learn that the name of Kohler and Milstein. Clark and Adams, so they discovered the ELISA test in plant virus detection, and specifically they developed the DAS ELISA. Actually ELISA is of two types. ELISA is of two types. The ELISA test is done for basically for viral the viral diseases. So ELISA is of two types. It is DAS ELISA and it is DAC ELISA. What is DAS and DAC? I will teach you in the genetics chapter, in the genetics lecture. Goodman discovered single-stranded DNA in Gemini viruses. So I told you that the Gemini Verity group, about the Gemini Verity group, and Goodman was the scientist who discovered the single-stranded DNA in them. Now we will see plant disease control, the history related to plant, like Milardet, Uveano, Bordox. Von Schemmling and Marshall Kulka. Schemmling and Kulka, first systemic fungicide, also known as carboxin. It is very much asked in the examination, a favorite question for the examiner to make. And the first systemic fungicide, carboxin. Now, New and Kerr. New and Kerr, in 1972, the first biological control of bacterial disease, like the crown gall disease, using A. virulent strains of Agrobacterium radiobacter. So Agrobacterium radiobacter is a strain of Agrobacterium. The A. virulent strain of Agrobacterium radiobacter was taken in order to treat the bacterial disease crown gall, and it was first done by New and Kerr. Now, plant pathology in India, in the Indian context, the first scientist is K.R. Krithikar. So he is the first Indian scientist who collected and identified fungi in India. E.J. Butler, father of plant pathology in India, also the father of mycology in India, and he wrote the book Fungi and Diseases in Plants. Okay, so the name of the book is Fungi and Diseases in Plants. B.B. Mundkar, he worked on the control of cotton wilt through varietal resistance. So cotton wilt, he was working on cotton wilt, and he established the Indian Phytopathological Society at IERI. Also, he wrote a journal, the name Indian Phytopathology, in the name of the society, and he authored a book, Fungi and Plant Diseases. Now, here is a slight bit of confusion. Like E.J. Butler, he wrote the book, see, Butler and Mundkar. These are two different scientists, okay. Now, Butler wrote the book, Fungi and Diseases in Plants. Fungi and diseases in plants. While Mundkar wrote the book Fungi and Plant Diseases. So you have to learn these two names and who was the author of which book, because the examiner sometimes asks in the examination, and the students usually tend to get confused at this point. Now about nematology. So nematology, J.T. Needham. They discovered the first plant parasitic nematode, PPN, and the first plant parasitic nematode was Anginia triticide. So this nematode was parasitic to plant. Okay, H.C. Bastian. H.C. Bastian is known as the father of nematology. And N.A. Cobb, father of modern nematology, American nematology. Hewitt, Ruskey and Goheen, the first reported the viral transmission by nematode. See, we know that virus is transmitted through aphids, through whitefly. We all know that. But virus transmitted through nematode was found by Hewitt, Ruskey and Goheen, and they were transmitting the grapevine fan leaf virus disease in USA. Grapevine fan leaf virus by Xiphanema index, it is usually transmitted, and the name Xiphanema index, it's a nematode, and it transfers this virus. G. Thorne, he wrote the book Principles of Nematology, and it is regarded as the Bible. Means it's an important book for nematology, written by G. Thorne. Now in India, nematology, we talk about Barber. Barber reported the root knot nematode infesting tea in Kerala. So the first plant parasitic nematode of India was reported in tea, in case of tea in Kerala, by Barber. Okay, C.A. Barber. Butler. Butler reported Ufra disease in rice. Okay, Ufra is also a nematological disease. It was reported by Butler. In 1966, now here are some important dates. 1966, division of nematology. So when the Green Revolution was started, at that time a division of nematology was established at IRI after 3 years in 1969, Nematological Society of India was founded. So first a division was made, then a society was founded after 3 years. Then after 2 years, 1971, Indian Journal of Nematology was published. And after 6 years, in 1977, the All India Crop Improvement Project on Nematode Pest of Crops. So crop AICRP was applied on the nematodes. So it is the AICRP on the nematode pest, which was done in 1977. So the date you should learn, like 1966 was the division. Then after 3 years, in 1969 was the society it was made. 71 the Indian Journal of Nematology, and 77 the AICRP. Now economically important diseases. Some economically important diseases here. What you should learn is the year, okay, and the place. Year and the place is important. Like for the late blight of potato, it should be. Late blight of potato, okay. Irish famine, 1845. You know the causal organism, it's Phytophthora, okay. Phytophthora infestans. So, Phytophthora infestans caused the late blight of potato. Now, coffee rust caused by Hemelia vestetrix. And it occurred in Sri Lanka. Now the dates are important. Like for the late blight of potato, 1845 is a very important date. Okay. Now for coffee rust, 1867 is an important date. Sri Lanka. Downy mildew of grape, 1880s, by Plasmopara viticola. Brown spot of rice, Helminthosporium, in West Bengal, 1943. So first is the late blight of potato. This year is very important. Second, coffee rust. Third is the brown rust, brown spot of rice, Helminthosporium, in West Bengal. Now the bacterial blight of rice was caused by Xanthomonas oryzae pathovariety. It's a bacterial disease in West Bengal, 1963. Okay, this is monotrichous in nature, means a single flagella is formed, and in 1963, so in West Bengal. Southern corn leaf blight, 1970, USA. So all these diseases are important economically, because these diseases somehow told us the economic importance of diseases and what diseases could do at an economical level and how much damage can they cause. So hence these are economically important diseases. Now we will see some miscellaneous points related to history, like H.M. Ward. H.M. Ward is the father of tropical plant pathology. Tropical. Erickson gave the physiological specialization in the fungus stem rust. So he gave this specialization, the physiological specialization in the stem rust. D.W. Day, he gave the concept of pathover. And McKinney, he gave the concept of cross production. Cross production is similar to vaccine. Like if an attenuated virus is injected in a plant, is given to a plant, that plant gets protection, okay, from that particular species of virus and also the related strains of that particular virus. This is called cross protection. Holmer gave the local lesion assay. Koch, Fankush, and Rusk. He observed these three observed TMV in the electron microscope. So this was all for the history point of view. And if you want more knowledge, or if you want more questions on on the for the GRF point of view, you can join the Telegram channel. Okay, you can join the Telegram channel, link in the description. Link in description I will provide you, and you can join the Telegram channel. So we will meet you in the next video. Until then, thank you guys.